ओके, एम आई ऑडिबल आजे?
यस सर।
ओके, सो ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट लेक्चर सो वी हैव कवर्ड दैट गायरोस्कोप लास्ट टू थ्री बिट्स, वन इज रिलेटेड टू द टू व्हीलर, स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द टू व्हीलर, एंड अनदर वॉज रिलेटेड टू द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द फोर व्हीलर. सो दैट वी हैव सीन. सो जस्ट आई विल ओपन दैट वंस अगेन. So I have some additional slides. So this we have seen, but this is somewhat different slide I am showing. Already we have seen angle of fill. This theta is nothing but the angle of fill. So it will be asked during the final examination. Then stability of four wheel vehicle negotiating the turn. So we have seen various reactions that W by 4, P by 2 and Q by 2. So this is W by 4, P by 2 and Q by 2 on inner wheel as well as on the outer wheel. This is the these are the parameters with respect to that. So this we have seen a reaction due to the weight of vehicle, that is RW is equal to W by 4, and here it is directly written as a mg by 4. Then effect of gyroscopic couple due to fill, that already we have seen gyroscopic couple due to four wheel, that is Cw is equal to 4 times, 4 wheels are there, so therefore I omega omega p, that is the general formula, we need to multiply it by 4, remember this. Then effect of gyroscopic couple due to the engine. So how to calculate for the engine? So it is specified by CE and is equal to IE into omega E into omega P. So we know that gear ratio or the speed ratio in terms of omega E, so that G is equal to omega E upon omega W, already we have seen. So here G is equal to omega E upon omega W. So accordingly this the omega E we are putting in terms of G and omega W. So here this is written instead of this. So therefore total gyroscopic couple is equal to C due to the wheel, C due to the engine. So this is the total gyroscopic couple. Now when wheels and rotating parts of the engine rotate in the same direction, then positive sign is taken, otherwise there is negative sign. That means whenever engine and wheels are rotated in the same direction, in that case we are going to take plus sign and minus sign if they are rotating in the opposite direction. So this way, now this vehicle, whatever displayed on the screen, it is coming towards us and it is taking a left turn. It is taking left turn. So therefore, it is lifting from the inward side and we are observing here this arrow, which indicates it is lifting, and outer wheels there is depressing. Upper wheels are depressing. So here we have shown reaction in the downward direction, and here we have shown reaction in the upward direction. So this is outer wheel, this one is inner wheel. So wherever it is turning, that wheel we are going to consider as the inner wheel, and this one is the outer wheel. So you can check this. Here we have shown reaction in the upward direction. So this one is outer wheel, this one is inner wheel. So outer wheels are depressed. High arrow khalcha bajula dakhavlay ani techi reaction outer wheel la kuta asnar hai varcha bajula. This is the reaction shown there. So the gyroscopic couple tends to press the outer wheel and lift the inner wheel. This is for the okay. Then in the same manner we need to find out its exact reaction. This one is the gyroscopic couple. So this is the vehicle, four wheeler. This is inner, these are the inner wheel, these are the outer wheels, and they are separated with distance x.
Rain is not visible.
1 minute. Was issue with the internet. Now I have connected my mobile internet. Now screen is visible to everybody.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are going to consider here it is x distance. Okay. So couple value is cg. It is represented by cg. So any one of P. So let's consider this P is nothing but the magnitude of reaction at two outer and inner wheels. That is P. So you can consider this is one point. I will write here O, and here I will write P, and this one is the distance. Now to get this P, that is the reaction, so we have, so this reaction occurs due to this gyro couple. So we are going to write this P into x is equal to, now this is related to one wheel, this is related to the one wheel, right? So this cg is equal to, what is this, p into x, that is also couple. So this is in the newton, and this one is the distance. So newton meter, that is nothing but the couple. Now rotor reaction on each inner wheel and the outer wheel. So P is equal to, we can write CG upon X. So this is the reaction on two inner wheels. These are the inner wheels, these are the outer wheels. So two wheels are there, and what is reaction? P is equal to CG upon X. So reaction on one wheel, this divided by 2. So CG upon 2 times X, that is shown there. So this is about reaction due to the gyroscopic couple. Then reaction due to effect of centrifugal couple. So already similar to the two wheeler. So this is centrifugal force. We can write in terms of mu square divided by R. So CC is equal to mu square H into R. So this one is the height. So it is acting in this direction. So it is also in the outward direction. So this will also tends to tilt the vehicle as shown in the figure. So due to the centrifugal couple, the vertical reaction on the road surface will be produced. So the reaction will be vertical upward on the outer wheel and vertical downward on the inner wheel. So due to the centrifugal force, there will be one couple, and that couple we are going to call it as centrifugal couple. Again, in the same way, here we are going to consider F. Here it is X. So F into X is equal to centrifugal couple. So we can write like this. This F by 2, I am writing directly, and CC by 2X. So this 2 I have written directly. That will give reaction on each inner or outer wheel. So F by 2 is equal to CC by 2X, and previously we have seen P by 2 is equal to CG by 2X. So in the same direction this will act. Okay, so total reaction at each outer wheel, so we have seen this is W by 4, then P by 2, and then Q by 2. So just I will show this. So on one of the outer wheel, you can check this diagram. So this is outer wheel, this is also outer wheel, and these are the reactions. So all are acting vertically upward. So addition we are going to take. Here this W by 4 acting in upward direction, these two are in the downward direction. This is in upward direction, these two are in downward direction. So reaction on each inner wheel, that is W by 4 is equal to W by 4 minus P by 2 and minus Q by 2. So this is about gyroscope. Now just I will show you some of the MCQs. And once again, you should remember that you need to focus on whatever MCQs I am providing So all the PDF copies. So till today I have provided you 4 PDFs consisting MCQs of 4 chapters, and remaining 4 also are ready. So you should focus, concentrate on those MCQs along with the study. So those are the important thing or important suggestion from my side. Okay. So what type of MCQs on this chapter will be asked? You can check. A disc is spinning with angular velocity omega radian per second about axis of spin. The couple applied to disc causing precession will be. So already we have seen there is formula to calculate the couple I omega omega P. So this one is the answer, where I is equal to mass moment of inertia of the disc and omega P angular velocity of precession. Remember that. Again, some of the MCQs will be asked in this way also. So what is that? So a disc spinning on its axis at 20 radian per second, omega P is given. Omega is given. Disc spinning on x on its axis, that omega is given directly, will undergo precession when torque 100 newton meter is applied about an axis normal to the angular speed. So C is given. So value of couple is given. So C is equal to I omega omega P. So value of I is given, right? Omega is given, value of I is given. So we can find out the value of omega P by writing C is equal to I omega omega P. So value of I is given, value of omega is given, and value of torque is given. So from that, this will be the answer. Then these are the some of the MCQs regarding the effect of gyroscopic couple. So whatever PDF copies I am sending along with the answer, which are shown with blue text, those are the answers. So you should prepare those MCQs for your final examination. So this is about MCQs on the gyroscope. Now I will start a new chapter from this, that is brake . So this is the content with respect to the syllabus of brake. So classification of brake, band brake, band and block brake, internal and external shoe brakes, and design considerations of the brake. Now, you know, for the vehicle, there is one control system, and that is called as a brake system. Another control system, that is called as a steering system. So whenever vehicle is running, brake is used to stop the vehicle. Brake is used to slow down the vehicle. So application of brake is used in the automobile, and it is under the control system. So vehicle la control madhe thevnyasathi steering system, that is also control system. Brake system, that is also control system. Then suspension system, that is running system. So whenever vehicle is running, during that suspension is used, or suspension system functions to give the comfort. So in the introduction, what is brake? Brake is the device by means of which artificial frictional resistance is applied to a moving machine member in order to retard or stop motion of a machine or any rotating component. So in this process, the brake absorb kinetic energy of moving member or potential energy given up by the object being lowered by the hoist or the elevators. So the energy absorbed by the brakes is dissipated in the form of heat, and this heat is dissipated in the surrounding air. So generally brakes are, so these are the some of the examples, so you can check out. So this is the example of brake, a schematic diagram of the brake. So for example, I'm showing, right? So this one is the rotating drum. This is rotating drum, and such brake shoe. These are the brake shoes, and we are going to provide spring force, and the application of force is made between these two brake shoes to apply the brake. So generally, this is rotating component. This one is rotating component, and it is stopped with the help of these brake liners. So kinetic energy is converted into heat energy, and it is dissipated in the surrounding. So whatever energy absorbed by the brakes, that has been dissipated in the surrounding. So that energy is absorbed after application of the brake. So gaadi la ekada veg yeto, means speed yeto, so it is having some kinetic energy. So that you know the basics. Then this is another example of the handbrake or the parking brake. So this is somewhat different brake, and used to stop or to maintain stationary condition of the vehicle. Then this is another example of the brake. Just images I am showing so that you will understand what is brake. This one is the rotating drum. Again, these are the lines. So basically, the capacity of the brake depends upon the following factor. So you need the pressure between the braking surfaces. You need pressure between the braking surfaces. Now suppose this one is the rotating drum. This is rotating drum, and it is rotating in this direction. There will be some axle on the shaft, and here a liner is provided, and there is frictional material. A layer is provided, and force is applied in this direction to stop the rotating. So the whatever pressure is applied, or that can be applied, based on that capacity of the brake is decided. Okay. Then coefficient of friction between the braking surfaces. So there are different materials wherein frictional resistance or coefficient of friction of different material. So So that is having some different values based on coefficient of friction of the material used, then peripheral velocity of the brake drum cha speed kiti ahe tyachyavar depend ahe, then projected area of the frictional surfaces. So what is width of liner, then ability of the brake to dissipate heat equivalent to energy being absorbed. So whatever energy absorbed, so whatever dissipation capacity of the brake, so it should dissipate the heat in the surrounding quickly so that it will not affect the frictional coefficient or coefficient of friction. So as heat increases, there is decrease in the coefficient of the friction. So whatever brakes or that material, it should have ability to dissipate heat into the surrounding at faster rate. So based on that, so next essential characteristics of the material for brake line. So this part we are going to call it as a brake lining. This one is the brake lining. This is brake lining. This black portion, brake lining. This one is brake shoe. This one is rotating drum. So the brake lining, for the brake lining, what are the essential characteristics are required? So high coefficient of friction with minimum fading. Already in the last slide I have told that whenever the temperature increases, there is decrease in the coefficient of the friction. So coefficient of friction should remain constant with change in the temperature up to certain level. So high coefficient of friction with minimum fading. Kadhi kadhi brake dabto apan, brake press karto, and still vehicle is not stopping. आपण म्हणतो ब्रेक फेड झाले, मीन्स वॉट एवर फ्रिक्शनल कोएफिशियंट दॅट हॅज बीन डिक्रीज्ड विथ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर चेंज इन द टेम्परेचर. ओके, सो ब्रेक मटेरियल इट शुड हॅव लो वियर रेट. जिजण्याचा रेट कमी असावा, राईट. इट शुड हॅव low wear rate. That is the essential characteristics of brake lining. Then high heat resistance. So it should have heat dissipation capacity. Then high heat dissipation capacity. Then adequate mechanical strength. Then no effect of moisture or and oil. So these are the essential characteristics of material for brake line. So you should remember, it should have high heat dissipation capacity, it should have adequate mechanical strength. So there should not be effect of moisture or oil, and it should have low wear rate and high coefficient of the friction. So this may be asked for the MCQ. Okay. Then some of the materials and their coefficient of friction and allowable pressure. So cast iron on cast iron, bronze on cast iron, steel on cast iron, wood on cast iron, fiber on metal, cork on metal, leather on metal. So this is the rotating drum. So just I will draw one more diagram. This one is rotating drum. So cast iron on cast iron, then bronze on cast iron, fiber on metal, cork on metal, leather on metal. So we can use cork as a friction material, leather as a friction material, wire, asbestos as a frictional material, only asbestos blocks as a frictional material, and depending upon the condition, operating condition, their coefficient of friction is changing and it has different range. So here you can take example of cork. So cork on metal, it has coefficient of friction in dry condition 0.35. whenever there is grease in between metal and the cork, it has been decreased in the range 0.25 to 30, and when lubricated it is degraded to 0.22 to 0.25, and allowable pressure 0.05 to 0.10 newton per mm square. Similarly, you can take this another example, leather on metal. Its coefficient of friction is 0.3 to 0.5. Again, it is decreased to 0.15 to 0.20 whenever grease is there, and it again decreases whenever it is lubricated. So in dry condition it has more value, and again it is decreases for the grease and the lubricated conditions. Okay. Now what are the functions of the brake? So it retard or stop the motion of machine temporarily when brakes are applied, or to stop the motion of the machine. That is the function. It converts kinetic energy into friction and dissipate the heat to the atmosphere. That is the function of the brake. It acts as a safety device. So then the classification of brakes. So here brakes, shoe brake, band brake. So first the difference. So this is disc, and such shoe inside the disc, and this is disc, and on that disc such bands are provided. That is called as a band brakes. So again, these shoe brakes are classified in two ways, one is external shoe brake, another one is internal shoe brake. That means internally expanding and externally contracting. Then band brakes, band and block brakes. This one is the another type. So in case of internal shoe brake, again mechanical, hydraulic and the pneumatic. In case of band brake, simple, differential, these are the two types, and band and block, simple and the differential. So these brakes are classified in number of ways. Just I will show one more thing so that you will understand different types of brakes. So this is the function. Already we have seen to slow down or stop the vehicle, to control the speed of the vehicle at turns. Then this is the classification: foot brake, hand brake. Then based on the mode of operation, so whatever we have seen in short way, that you can check. So here I will show some of the diagrams. Rotating drum, this one is brake liner, this one is the brake liner, this one is the disc brake, this is rotating disc which is mounted on the wheel, and such chambers. So this is additionally I am showing. Okay, this is again image of the disc brake. Then so you can check hand brake. Hydraulic brake system. Here again brake shoes are there, so system operates on principle of Pascal's law. This is again schematic of hydraulic brake system. This is only for your information, not in the syllabus. This is hydraulic brake system. Air brake system used in the bus. Then these are the vacuum brakes. These are the servo brakes. Anti-lock braking system. Okay. So this is the classification. Only classification is important with respect to your syllabus. Then, now, with respect to our syllabus, so there are two types. So first, we will see single block or shoe brake. So here, the single block or shoe brake is shown in the figure. So it consists a block. So this one is the block, and it is pressed against the rim or the wheel. This one is the wheel. So this block is made up of some of the softer material than the rim material. This is important. So whatever frictional material or the material used to apply the brake, that should be soft than the rim material. So this type of brake is used commonly in trains, railways, or the tram cars. So this will be asked in MCQ. So there is one more MCQ with respect to this. So just I will show for your information. The brakes commonly used in railway trains. Shoe brake. Okay. So this one is used in case of the railway or the train, the whatever friction between the block and the wheel, that will cause a tangential force. So just I will show, this one is the tangential force, and that is denoted by FT. So the block is pressed against this rotating wheel. So this is schematic diagram, and this one is the lever, and this one is the fulcrum point. A lever ahe, it a block ahe, and force is applied at the end of the lever. So this block is rigidly mounted on this lever, and this one is rotating. So when brake needs to be applied, we need to have force at this end, and this one is the distance of P from the fulcrum. So you can check this one more sentence only I have shown here. A single block brake line of action of the tangential force passes through the fulcrum of the lever. So this one is the fulcrum of the lever, and this FT is passes through the line, so along this line. So clockwise rotation of brake wheel, it is shown here. So some of the parameters you can check: P, force applied at the end of lever; Rn, normal force pressing the brake block, that is normal reaction, here it is shown; R, radius of the wheel; 2 theta, angle of contact surface of the block; mu, coefficient of friction; and Ft, tangential braking force, or the frictional force acting at the contacting surfaces of the block. Now in this case, we need to assume that if the angle of contact is less than, this one is the angle of contact. This one is the angle of contact. Then it may be assumed that normal pressure between the block and wheel is uniform. In such case, the tangential braking force on the wheel. So this FT we can write like this. So FT is equal to mu R n t is equal to mu r n. This is the equation number 1. This is the equation number 1. Now, breaking torque, how to find out the breaking torque? So, force into the radius, that is nothing but the breaking torque. So, again, we can write like this, TB is equal to, this is force into the radius, into the radius, this R you need to consider. So, tangential braking force, this one is the tangential braking force, and braking torque is equal to Ft into R. हे लक्षात ठेवा, ही एमसीक्यू साठी महत्त्वाचं आहे. सो टेंजेंशियल ब्रेकिंग फोर्स एफ टी इज इक्वल टू म्यू आर एन अँड ब्रेकिंग टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू एफ टी इंटू आर. ओके, सो नाउ लेट अस कन्सिडर. सो three cases with respect to this. First one, when the line of action of the tangential braking force Ft passes through the fulcrum O of the lever and the brake wheel. So this one is the first case, already we have seen. Now, this is the first case. So, clockwise rotation of the brake wheel. So, we need to take the moment about this O. This is O. How to take moment? So, this is Rn. So, just I will draw figure here. O. Here Rn, this is x, so we can write like this, Rn into x is equal to, this is acting in this direction, is equal to this P into L, P into L, this one is the P, and from this fulcrum it is at L. So we can get this Rn is equal to P into L divided by X, divided by X. So, this is about the braking torque. So, braking force we got value as, so previously we have already seen this braking force is equal to mu Rn and braking torque is equal to Ft into R. Now, just by taking the moment about fulcrum O, we got the value of Rn by writing the equation Rn into X is equal to P into L, or directly Rn is equal to P into L divided by X. Now remaining part we will take in the next lecture. So I am just sending one more MCQ test, that test number 3 now. So that link will be open till tomorrow morning 9:30. You can solve. So that will which will consist of MCQs related to the chapter number two, that is velocity and the gyroscope. Okay, so you can type your roll number in chat box.